fast-paced. I think speed is definitely one of the ones that I remember, like fast progress in a short period of time.
So you have on the one hand some fun in your team, and on the other hand, for sure, some pressure. 3 months might be a long time to work on products, but in the end, it's not that much time. So the idea is to come up with the best user-friendly product within these 3 months.
We've got agile coaches here at DPS. Now, the coaches are actually constantly supporting the teams. So there's either an agile coach around or a team buddy. And when questions arise, like how do I do a stand-up, how do I do a retrospective, how I actually plan for the next week, there's always somebody around who will help with these questions.
Yeah, basically you are working in so-called cross-functional teams in the DPS. You have on the one hand students, talents from all over the world, and on the other hand you have experienced guys from the companies. And each team consists of a product manager, of a user interface designer, as well as a software engineer and an artificial intelligence expert.
First big challenge for the team is to get their head around the problem space, identify target groups, and do problem interviews with those target groups. And out of those problem interviews, the teams generate so-called how might be questions.
So the problem space is ride sharing in a broad sense. What we did in the first place is going out and ask people. The how might we question is how might we motivate drivers to give a ride? Because this is what we found out was the main burden for current ride-sharing solutions, to have tons of passengers who want to get a ride, but not a lot of suppliers in this way.
Then the teams ideate on possible solutions regarding that one how might we question, to end up with the one solution that tackles the problem best. And after that, that solution is being built using agile methods, lots of experiments as well, in order to make sure that the thing they decided on building, that is built the right way. You can tell once the teams do this, they go out, talk to users, test with users, and they come back. They're really excited about the things they found out. So in the first user test, it's like trying to drink from a fire hose. So many impressions they get, so many ideas they have, so many opportunities they see.
The main idea is fail fast, fast forward. That means go out to ask as many people as possible, to get as many insights as possible, to test as many different prototypes as possible, so to validate each idea as often as possible to come up with the best user-friendly product in the end. So it's all about validation.
Our week starts on a Friday, planning for the next week. So the idea is to think about what is it that we want to achieve as a team in the next week, and then make a rough plan for the next week. Every Friday, it's also the day where we have our review meeting. This is an opportunity for every team to present what they have achieved during the week. Every morning, the team comes together for a stand-up meeting and discussing what is it that we want to achieve today. Are there any roadblocks? Is there anyone who needs support? So the team in the morning knows what they want to achieve on that day.
You have the basic idea of fake it till you make it. So that means you start with the first easy paper prototypes and go out and asking users for their feedback. And then you try to implement the first click dummies, so-called click dummies, for example, a web-based or a smartphone or a tablet-based click dummy. Go out again and to get more and more feedback on your functionalities, on your products. As soon as you are able, you start coding the real-time applications. So the idea is to come up with a final prototype as well as a real-time application in the end of the program.
So the solution, maybe to sum it up, is a ride-sharing application for inner city, a regular basis, and on the fly. On the one hand, people said, I don't want to have strange people coming into my car. On the other hand, when I did ride-sharing in the past, I met interesting people. And as soon as we had the idea of putting this bonus added, like the growing your network and matching the right people via social media interfaces into the solution, we actually got very good feedback from the people we tested it with.
I mean, there are differences and there must be differences between DPS time and your time in your company. So first you have one issue, one problem you are focused on, and you have this extremely user-centric approach. You try to get as many insights from the customers to develop the perfect digital product. For me as a product manager, it was quite interesting to get as familiar as possible with agile methods and to work with these measures over 3 months. As well as you have the DPS framework, the DPS coaches, which try to help you to get answers on questions. And finally, you have this network of experienced partners. And so from my point of view, a perfect environment within this DPS program.
I think the retros once a week, where you just dedicate the entire hour to the team and not to the topic. For me, that made us the team that we became, because we were really giving us very honest but very respectful feedback. From a project management perspective, I definitely have to say the tools that we were giving with is something that I will take with me. And if it's just the dailies, that in the end, when it was very important to use them, we did it very stoically, and it was working perfectly because we had all the transparency in the world and we just knew who was working on which topic and which challenges this person was facing, and we could support.
Participants are used to thinking things through from start to finish before doing the first step. We want to bring across that failing means learning, and so we really force the teams to fail. And to me, that's the bare essential to working agile.